been a busy morning, so we've been installing the indoor beehive, or the observation beehive, at the Woodville Library, and it's been 13 months in the making. So we actually had to move the hive outside. We moved them in, made them welcome, brought them all in, attached the chute, and now we're just waiting for them to navigate their way out from the chute and figure it all out, because everything's changed in terms of their flying patterns, yeah. See the bees, you can actually listen to them, and at times you get a waft of honey and coming through, so it's a visible hive, an observation hive, and this is a great place where education can take place. It's really exciting, and you know, I guess a first for a council too.
Because you can't buy these things off the shelf, it's all been designed by one very clever person, Bob Beer. He made the observation hive, he's made the podium for it. He's created the chute, and it's fantastic. You don't go into the shop and say, I'd like an observation hive. It all has to be built on the fly.
Quite simply, every third spoonful of food that goes into your mouth is a pollinated food. And it may not necessarily be pollinated by bees, but bees are responsible for something like 70% of our pollinated food. Where would the world be without bees? Well,
the library is one of those places which I think once upon a time it was a place of shush, and this is just about books, but I think libraries have evolved significantly over time, not just to be about books, but a place where people can connect and learn all sorts of things in new ways. And what an amazing thing to be able to experience the world of bees up close and personal.
This is not intended as a pun, but the kids make a bee line to the beehive. There'll be children who'll come in and they'll go home and they'll talk about them, and let's go back to the library. I want to see those bees, Mummy. See if they're still going in and out of that chute.
It's been an exciting thing to see it finally come together. We've been talking, planning, working, organising, you name it, and everything was ready except for the little bees. So now we have a lot of new residents of the Civic Library, so I'm pretty happy, and it looks like it's working, which is even better.